Alright guys, it's Harshit Tihami. Today I'm going to teach you guys how to handle objects and images inside a frame. When you resize the main frame, it often stretches just like this one. So this is the main frame for the mobile. I'm going to call it onboarding screen just for the reference. Now when you resize this particular frame, you can see the icon right here. It stretches according to the width and height of that particular frame. So how to handle that? If I zoom in and select this icon, let's call it icon, in the layer panel, so you can see that this icon is a group right now. The vectors are grouped together. And how did I know that it is a group, not a frame? It's a simple trick. These are the symbols for groups, frame, or auto layout frames. So when you see this symbol in the layer panel, that represents a frame like this one. We've got onboarding screen, which is a frame. And if you see this symbol, the dotted box, it is a group just like this one that we were discussing. Or if you see these symbols in the layer panel, it actually represents an auto layout. What auto layout is, we can discuss it later in some of the tutorial, but for now, ignore that. All right, so what you want to do is to handle this icon, right now is inside a group, so I have to frame it. I have to define it in a frame. So how do I do that? I press the right click on that object and press this frame selection. You can also press Control Alt G to make a frame, and that's it. Now that icon is inside a frame, and if I stretch my main frame, shouldn't be calling it a mainframe. Mainframe is something else, but yeah, let's call it a mainframe right now. So if I resize it now, it won't disturb this particular icon. One more thing, actually two more things. First would be the consistency, or the best way to handle these situations. Right now it is, if you see in the layer panel, we've got a frame, and then within that frame we've got a group of two different objects. So this is not a really good practice. So what you might want to do is, you might want to get rid of this particular group. To do that, you can either press Control Shift G to ungroup, or just go inside this by clicking right click on it and press this ungroup right here. Now we can see that these two vectors are inside this frame. One more thing, if you want to, right now these two are two different objects. If you want to merge them together, you have to select these two objects, right click on it, and we've got flatten, Control E, or you can just press Control E, and that's it. Now it's one object. It was a basic tutorial. And last thing, sometimes when you create a new frame, the Figma places that particular frame outside the main frame. So what happens is something like this. The frame is defined outside my main frame, and the indication of this is we've got the small letters or the name of that particular frame written right above it. So that means this frame is hanging out of that main frame. It's not part of that main frame anymore. What's the drawback here? So if I move around my main frame, you can see that the icon isn't moving around with that main frame anymore. I don't want that, because I might be using this in my prototype, or I might be exporting this particular frame, and if I export it as a PNG, this icon would not be a part of that PNG. That's not good. So I don't want that. And if I don't want that, I have to make sure that this particular icon or the frame is inside or within that main frame. And yeah, that's all I can think of right now. Maybe there are a few things that I have missed about frames or groups, and if there is anything that that you might find annoying, please report it to me in the comment section below, and I will try to make a video on it really soon. So if you like the tutorial, please like and subscribe, blah blah blah. Thanks a lot. Cheers.